Hi, welcome to Sona Motivates. Sona motivates you to eat healthy, be happy, and enjoy every moment. So today is week 22nd. It's today's spice is mace. So welcome to our spice series, week 22nd, and today's spice is mace. Three incredible health benefits of this amazing, you can say spice, but spectacular spice, and it's actually a covering. Yes, it's mace, and I somehow don't have the spice with me, so I'm going to go with the picture today. So I hope you guys can see. So this is actually mace, and what are these, we will see in a while, but just keep looking at these. This is our mace, and let me see who is here joining us in our okay, cool. So I see a couple of people here, and welcome, shoot me a hello so I can greet you guys as well. So I see Nimisha, I see Nisha joining in, thank you. So we are going to talk about the mace, and mace is actually a covering of a spice name which we have already seen previously, and it's nutmeg. Mace is a covering of nutmeg, and I was out of mace at home, so I just could print it at the last minute, so I printed it. But it's very, very beautiful. It's orange red in color, and it has a wonderful aroma, and it has a taste of, it's a mixed taste of cinnamon and pepper. Cinnamon and pepper together. Let me check once again, but yes, they together, it actually tastes like mace. Okay, yes, combination of pepper and cinnamon together, if you ground them together, how it will taste, that's how mace tastes. But it has its excellent its own aroma as well. But this is something very new. I learned about mace while studying about it, because you know, while we have always used mace in our garam masala powder, which we call the curry powder, the specific curry powder which we make for the which is black colored. So we have always used mace in those, and maybe couple of times in biryani or pulao. But I had no idea that it is so medicinal and it can be used. But we are going to explore it together, and I'm super excited about it. Okay, so mace is actually it's native to Indonesia. So it's native to Banda Islands, which is one of the spice island from in Indonesia, and it is very commonly used in South Asian cuisine. Mace in India is called as Javitri. So if you guys don't know about Javitri, don't know about mace, I'm sure most of us know about Javitri, but it is very, very exciting. Okay, how come, just let me check, why am I not able to see the comments here? But anyway, I can see it in front here, that's okay. We will manage. So we were talking about mace and the color and everything. And one more exciting thing is, to produce 1 pound of mace, you have to actually, it requires around 400 pounds of nutmeg. So to take out the 1 pound of, because it is basically covering of nutmeg, so to produce 1 pound, you have to go through 400 pounds of nutmeg. It is very, very traditionally used in Ayurvedic medications, the mace. Okay, now Indonesia and Granada are the world's largest producers, high quality producers of mace and even nutmeg. But and they together produce around 95% of the production of mace and nutmeg. But rest 5% is produced by India, then Malaysia and Sri Lanka. Okay, so this is all about the production of mace and how it is. It is a small tree, we have seen as previously in nutmeg, it's the same thing. Then let's jump to our first health benefit, because it's very, of course we have seen some spices which are very very beneficial for brain health, but this is in itself is an excellent spice for stimulating the brain functionality, and it enhances the brain functionality. Isn't it amazing? So if in some way you can incorporate the spice in your kids' meal, it will be awesome. And actually a lot of research have shown that it even helps to treat the people with Alzheimer's, patients with Alzheimer's. So that's something, even I learned while researching about it. We have been, like I told you, we have been using mace in our garam masala curry powder, but never thought of it as such a beneficial spice for brain health as well. Yeah, and Nisha is saying used to make Rawalpindi chole masala. Oh, interesting. Can you post the recipe, Nisha, of Rawalpindi chole masala? I'm super excited to learn those things because I know the regular chole, but if you make your own curry powder, the chole curry powder, that is the chickpea curry powder, please make sure you post it. Okay, please. Okay, maybe the recipe of the curry powder or the whole recipe of the chickpea. Okay, sure. And then we will talk about our first health benefit, and that is it stimulates and enhances the brain functionality. How? It has the components named mesolignin and myristicin. So these both components, they help you stimulate the neural pathways and improves the cognitive function of the brain. Not only that, it actually improves the memory and retention. That's how I got to the point where they were talking about Alzheimer's. And one more thing is it is an excellent stress buster. So it actually boosts your mood. It increases the ability to pay attention while on work in the detailing. It induces calmness and peacefulness by taking away all the tensions and eliminating the anxiety. And with not only that, with these all qualities, it is actually excellent for mental exhaustion. So prior to this, we were using this as a curry powder, but now we are going to look into how we can use this spice, the mace, as a remedy, as a health remedy. And at the end of this video, I'm going to give four or five tips where you can incorporate. If you're not using the curry powder, that's okay. You don't have to go ahead and make your own, but you can definitely use these. You can use these health home remedies for incorporating spice in your life. Okay, now we are going to go to our second spice of benefit, and that is it actually protects your kidneys. And how? It has an excellent, it has all the great, it has calcium and minerals and vitamins and antioxidants, and it is anti-inflammatory, it is antifungal, antiviral. It has all the great qualities, the mace. And mace, because of its ability, it can protect kidneys from kidney stones or any kidney infection. And not only that, if you are suffering from kidney stones, it actually helps dissolve the kidney stones. And by treating, these mace, actually it helps the it's a great natural remedy for treating kidney infections and any other conditions that are attributed to the kidney's problem. So it is excellent for kidney health. And somehow I felt like this is actually mace, and these are the nutmegs. I just wanted to show you guys. But the mace, it has a very cute, maybe cute, its character, maybe it has that kind of appearance of a heart. It's kind of heart shaped, and that's what is one of the greatest benefit of mace, is it is actually very useful for the heart health. So it improves the heart functioning because it has lavish great amount of potassium in it. And potassium is a very important mineral for human heart health. It helps the strengthening the heart. So while it has this ability to relax the blood vessels, it is best for hypertension also. So mace not only protects heart, it is great for hypertension that is the blood pressure. Now, regular intake of mace actually not just keeps the heart healthy, it also controls the blood pressure. If you can somehow incorporate maize, then it will help you in maintaining your healthy blood pressure as well. And I see Sunita and Sanjay joining. Thank you very much for joining. Let's learn about maize, and please keep posting your questions so I can interact with you, letting you guys know how helpful and healthy maize is. And maize is nothing but Javitri. That's what we call back home in India. Now, while adding maize to your cooking, you have to make sure that you add it at the beginning of the cooking, because unlike nutmeg we add at the end. Remember, while it's boiling or at the end after the coffee is done, that's how, when we add nutmeg. But for Javitri or for maize, you have to make sure you add it very much at the beginning, and preferably in the oil, because that's when it starts leaving its flavor and aroma. So far, it takes a while to get its aroma or flavor in the to the dish. So let it cook. Let your dish cook with the spice. Okay, you can use it in the whole form. That's what it is shown, the whole form. But if not, you usually get them. You can get them in a powder form. So you can use it that way too. Or what you can do is you can make your own powder. Hi Pratibha, thank you for joining. What you can do is you warm these nutmeg on a pan, and after cooling a little bit, powder it. And if you think the powder is too, crumble, it has a lot of crumbs in it, make sure you can sieve it. And then the remaining, the thin and very light powder, that's when you can use that powder for n number of medicinal purposes. That's what we are going to talk now. Okay, when we started with the maize, I told for those of my friends who join me later, that maize has a combination of flavor of like pepper and cinnamon together. It has a very strong aroma. It is covering of nutmeg. So to produce 400 to produce 1 pound of maize, you have to go through almost 400 pounds of nutmeg. So that's how, and that's why it is a little bit costlier than the other spices. Okay. Now, we will see how you can use nutmeg in cooking, but I really wanted to touch base this topic because I had to research it myself. We never used it for any medicinal purposes. Like with the previous spices, I always talked about how cinnamon I added to this and that for the lowering the diabetes, the blood sugar, or how we use the cloves for dental health, or all these maybe the carom seeds, how we used to use for cold and sinus problems. But we never used maize previously for any kind of health benefit apart from the garam masala. But now we are going to, just now we saw its amazing health benefits, and now we will see how you can use it. Definitely, like any other spice, you can make the tea, or I just say the boil water with these with nutmeg, sorry, with cinnamon and maize in it. Boil it nicely. If you take 4 cups of water, let it reduce to 3 cups, and drink this tea or water with maize, and it is a great health. It has a health benefit of for your heart, for indigestion, and it actually helps all any problem of inflammation. So if you have any arthritis pain or any kind of inflammation, that's with this kind of tea or water, it can be actually reduced. So try using this thing. Okay, then what is the next one? And this is very amazing. It has eugenol as well. So it is great for your oral health, or your tooth, any kind of teeth problem. So in while brushing your teeth in the morning or even at night, you can just sprinkle a little bit of nutmeg, sorry, of the maize powder on your toothpaste and brush it. And this is how it will actually, it protects your oral health as well. It is antibacterial, so it helps keep your mouth clean. It actually also helps the halitosis we talked about. Remember a couple of weeks back, in one of the spice that I think it's cloves. Yes, in cloves, because it also has eugenol, and because of that, in those people who suffer from a very bad breath, and no matter what they do, they cannot get rid of the bad breath. It is because of that specific type of bacteria. But you know, the spice mace is actually it's actually believed that it can heal halitosis as well. Okay, so this is great for you know, oral health, and you can add a pinch to the toothpaste brush, and that's how you can use it. Okay, one more thing is you can take one proportion in one-to-one quantity of this mace oil and olive oil or even almond oil, and mix it together, and you can rub on any kind of inflammation you have. You know, instead of any kind of you know, taking any painkillers, try to use this oil on your joints or any kind of inflammatory pain you are feeling from, and try this remedy. It actually you feel relieved within a couple of hours. So it's proven that any kind of mace oil and any carrier oil, olive oil, or you can use even coconut oil, or you can use the almond oil. Okay, and we just talked about it, the toothpaste. Okay, and the one more thing is if you are suffering from chronic headache, you know, migraine or sinus, or any kind of headache, what you can do is make a paste. Like if you have the powder, add milk to it, warm it, and apply the paste on your forehead. This not only helps relieve you from your headache, but it also helps you soothe down, calm down, and it actually helps you sleep better. So if you know, one of those days you are very stressed and you feel cranky and you can't sleep properly, try using mace powder with oil, sorry, with milk. Warm it, let it cool, you know, maybe at room temperature. Apply it to your forehead, leave it for a couple of minutes, and if it's okay if you leave it overnight, because you will sleep probably, and it is believed that it can treat insomnia as well. So mace is really, really very, very wonderful spice come medicine in your kitchen cabinet. And last but not least, there is one more home remedy, that is you use mace powder plus cinnamon powder and a little bit of honey. So together you mix it. Either in 1 teaspoon in the morning and evening you consume it through mouth, or for all overall health, or you can apply it to your skin. That's also because it helps you, you know, keep your skin healthy, and it also reduces the blemishes and the pimples. But not only this, but this specific paste, whatever the mixture we make, it actually helps you in all of these health benefits we talked about the heart health, about the stress buster, about you know, indigestion, inflammation, for the treating your blood pressure. So all these can be you know, catered towards by just using this one simple health remedy. So try these home remedies, and don't make sure you please comment and let me know how you feel. And somehow, okay, why don't I see the comments here? Okay, I started seeing the comments now. Okay, perfect. Okay, and now we are going to see how we can use them in our cooking. Okay, now I have talked it previously that we use in our garam masala powder, the curry powder. We also use mace in or jawitri in rice items like pilau or biryani. And I do see Jagdish joining in too. Hi Jagdish, thank you very much, all the way from California. Thank you for joining in, and thank you Sanjay from Dallas. And guys, keep posting your locations. That will be fun. To say hello with your location in. Okay, so next time you join me, please keep posting your location. That actually boosts us a little bit for doing this spice series. And you won't believe it's our 22nd week of spice. And we have been researching a lot and learning a lot about these spices. And specifically, I'm going to talk about today's spice mace. Even I was so oblivious towards these spices. You know, it was just there in our kitchen cabinet, but I've never see. I'm out of the spice, and I don't even have the spice to show you. So I have to show you the picture, but it's so beneficial, and I'm going to be very, very vigilant vigilant about this spice and from now on, and keep sure that make sure that I will always have that handy. Okay, and yeah, when I get this spice, I'll make sure that I'll post the picture in our comment section. So if you're still confused about what I'm talking about, please please see the comments later. So there will be a picture of the spice in our comment section. And oh, okay, so Nimisha is joining in from Dallas as well, which I knew, but thank you Nimisha for posting your location. Okay, and now we will jump over to our how we cook with maize. So maize, we saw how Indians cook with it, but it can be also enjoyed in any kind of sweet or savory dishes. So any kind of baking, you can use it in donuts if you make donuts, or you can use it in cakes and pastries and pies. It goes very well there. Okay, you can use them in barbecue sauce or cakes. Just now we talked about cheese dishes and cookies and curries and mashed potatoes. They go very well with mashed potatoes, and oh my god, they will be so awesome with mashed sweet potatoes. So make sure you try it. Okay, and then okay, oyster stew, they can be used, maize powder or maize can be used in puddings and pumpkin pie, spinach, Swedish meatballs, sweet potato pie, stuffing, squash, yams. So even a pinch of this this powder, this maize powder, this amazing spice can help you through so many health benefits. So isn't it amazing? These are like miracles of nature. You know, you can just add a little bit and it gives you so much. And I see, oh, Nisha is joining from Atlanta. Amazing. Thank you, Nisha. Okay, that's cool. Oh, we are literally around the globe. And I see Varsha joining in too. So, Varsha, can you specify your location from where you are joining us today? Okay, and we just talked about, oh, okay, just 20 minutes. I can still go for a couple of minutes. I'll just recap those who joined me later that we talked about maize, which is the covering of nutmeg. We talked about three amazing health benefits of this maize, and the first one was how it is excellent for stimulating and enhancing the brain functionality. It is amazing for protecting our kidneys. It helps in heart health, hypertension. It is great for any kind of inflammation in your body. It is excellent for skin. It is excellent and very, very helpful in oral health. And I can keep going because maize had so many health benefits. So it was actually very hard for me to, you know, recap and reduce them to just three important health benefits. But somehow these three, I found it very, very interesting. That's why we chose those. But maize is an amazing spice. So make sure you guys include it in your cooking. We have so many great things going on with Sona Motivates these days. We launched our Eat for Health program in our Sona Motivates, because remember a couple of months ago we talked about how we, a couple of 7-8 ladies, we came together and, you know, I was helping them. You cannot say just lose weight, but go towards a healthy lifestyle, lead a healthy lifestyle. So we changed the eating habits, incorporated a lot of great things in their meal, and how over the period of 6 to 8 months, how they felt better energy wise, their medications were reduced, and their vitals, you know, all their tests, what they used to do, you know, blood test and sugar test and all these tests were normal. And not only that, they had a lot of energy, they felt better. So our program is not towards before and after and that cosmetic changes just, but it is more towards about how you feel, how at the end of these couple of maybe 3 months, we have these 3 to 4 months of our program, and how you feel at the end of these 3 months. So it's more of the lifestyle you apply. So it's not a diet program where I just tell, okay, remove the carbs from your diet, go gluten free, don't do this, don't do that. It's not like that, because You cannot, this cannot be a lifestyle. You cannot live without, you cannot just discard any food from your food diary, from your daily diet, and then one fine day you will be it's not like that. I don't believe in that. You have to eat everything in moderation. You have to enjoy everything. You have to enjoy your food, and you have to be happy while eating. But if you have a balance of everything, a workout and eating and fruits and vegetables and all the healthy things in your life, then that becomes your lifestyle, and you are a happy soul, rather than you going on a diet. And I hear a lot about keto diet these days, and so many people are avoiding carbs, and especially wheat. And now wheat is again, once again, it's like a devil. It's like something evil, wheat, and people just shy away. Oh, wheat is grown this way and that way, and then everybody's running towards almond flour and coconut flour and this and that. And okay, everything these days is modified, right? So if we keep everything in your body, somehow I think, I believe it adapts to what you eat. I think, if we believe, if we are eating right, and if we believe that it's fueling you in a good way, it's helping you heal, it's keeping you happy, then nothing can harm you. It won't harm you. Because, but if you're scared of eating that food, it's surely because that's in your mind, and that's your body and the cells, and it starts working that way. I'm a very firm believer of the Secret book, and I do believe, what you think, so does it happen. So every thought counts. So if you believe your food is there to heal you, and like these spices, they are there to help you heal, feel better, then it's going to happen. But if you are scared of, oh my God, it's going to give me heartburn, oh my God, this wheat is going to give me some kind of gastric problem, trouble, then it's going to happen that way. So let's believe and put good vibes in our food. Eat it with full, wholeheartedly. Enjoy the food, and that way it won't harm you. Of course, we have to eat everything in moderation. Believe in working out. Take care of your thoughts. Do meditation. Enjoy. Be happy, enjoy your friends and families, company. And so, guys, have a very wonderful Thanksgiving. And I'm so thankful for you all for joining us every Tuesday, or watching this video later, or with our spice series. And this is amazing what we are doing. I am having time of life when I'm talking to you guys. Okay, there are so many comments here, but I'm going to. I kept on talking, and I get so carried away when I'm talking about eat for health or cook for health, because it's my passion. I believe, it will help people. But that's why, I cannot stop talking about it. But yes. Thank you, Tanishree, for joining. We are almost done with our today's spice, that was maize. Please make sure you watch the video. Make sure you guys comment, and I will answer your comments after this, after we are off live. So, thank you very much. Happy Thanksgiving to you too, and it's always a pleasure to see you. Please make sure you let us know which spice you would like to explore with us, so that way we will post next spice details, and we will try to research more about it, and we will talk about the spice you would like us to explore with you. So see you next week with a new spice, and stay tuned. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube videos. Check our sonamotivates.com and keep in touch. Bye, and thank you. Share, like, and don't forget to leave your valuable comment for us. Thank you, and bye. Have a nice night. Thanks. Bye.